What's going on, everybody? This is Living in Arizona Now, and today we are going to talk about the reasons why people leave Arizona. Let's do it. Now, just a quick disclaimer. There's lots of positive reasons why people are coming to Arizona. In fact, more people are moving to Arizona than leaving, but there are people who are actually leaving and they're fed up, and that's why we made this video. Okay, so the number one reason why people are leaving Arizona is because it's hot. So they've been here for maybe 3 years and they're sick and tired of the extended period of time where we get really hot temperatures. We're talking over 90, 95 degrees 6 months out of the year. And when you do that year after year and those long periods of time where we're well over 100, some people, they just can't handle that. So that heat is one reason why people want to get the heck out of Arizona. And one of the workarounds for that, if you have the money, is to become a snowbird. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but that's someone who follows the snowbirds. They go north for the summer, and they go south for the winter. It's basically the only workaround to getting away from that heat, unless you want to live here full time and deal with it. For me, I'm used to it, but I don't think I love it. All right, so here's a big reason why people want to leave. It's no longer relaxing anymore. It's become overpopulated in some of the big cities. Now, obviously, Arizona is more than just Phoenix, Tucson, Flagstaff, and Yuma. But what has happened in some of these major areas, even the small towns, is they just swelled up and grew too fast. They outgrew the infrastructure. They outgrew the roads. And now you have all of these communities where the roads are just jam-packed. And people are like, what the heck? This is no longer relaxing. This is frustrating because in Arizona, you really got to have a car. I mean, it's so spread out. It's not densely populated. But in the areas where there are population centers, it's very congested. So the state in and of itself, not densely populated. As you know, we have many Native American reservations, Indian reservations that you can account for, where there's pretty much no cities on any of those. But in the major urban areas, the cities, the small towns, they're getting overpopulated and people are like, that's not why I moved to Arizona. It's not relaxing anymore. So they want to leave because of that. And to piggyback on what I just spoke about, let's talk about cost of living. Back in 2012, 2014 even, it was really affordable to live in Phoenix, Tucson, Flagstaff. I mean, the cost of living out here was great. But over the last 5 years, in particular, the last couple years, the prices have just shot up, almost doubled in 2 to 3 years. So because of that, it's no longer as sought after because it's not as affordable as it used to be. I mean, we're looking at almost California or Washington prices where those housing markets were 3 years ago. They're now here in Scottsdale, in Phoenix, and in Gilbert. So that novelty of Phoenix being an affordable place to live, Tucson being an affordable place to live, it's kind of wearing off and it's becoming more expensive and people are like, hey, I need to move somewhere where it's not so expensive. So they're going to places like Kansas, North Dakota, South Dakota, where the prices are still fair, but then they got to deal with those brutal winters and all that other crazy weather that goes along with Kansas tornadoes and whatnot. Now remember, this list is not the reason why I am leaving Arizona or why I would. This is a list that's made from people in our groups and in our chat discussions in our communities saying this is why they want to leave Arizona, not because of me, okay? But let me expand on this right here in the next one. Okay, so the next one is lack of culture. Believe it or not, even though we have prehistoric peoples that lived here and we had the Spanish coming through here in the 1600s and we have modern history, the pioneers, people say that Arizona, believe it or not, lacks culture. Now again, this is not my opinion, but this is what people who want to leave, they always say, Arizona is a place that doesn't have culture. Some have even gone so far as to call Arizona a brain drain because our public education system is considered some of the lowest in the country, so it doesn't exactly produce intellectuals. Now I didn't say that, but people have said that. I would say we've got some pretty intelligent people in Arizona, but hey, this is why people want to leave. Now this one came up quite a few times in our community discussions as to why someone would want to leave. They said crime. They believe that crime is getting worse. When in reality, if you look at the data, crime is not actually getting worse in Arizona. It's stable. It's not going up and it's not really going down. But if anything, it was kind of on a downtrend over the last couple years. But this is a thing that people cite as a reason they want to leave Arizona. And I would say it depends on where you live in Arizona. If you live in, say, southwest Phoenix, you might find crime to be an issue. If you live in northeast Phoenix, yeah, crime might not be an issue really at all that you even think about. So again, it just depends on where you're coming from. So I can understand why people would say that. But a lot of times, I think it's just going to depend on where they select their location to be, because some areas do have higher crime than others, obviously. And here's another one that's come up quite a few times, health. So depending on what kind of health issue someone might have, Arizona can either be beneficial or not so beneficial. They say because of the air quality, it can be bad for people with asthma. And for some people, Arizona might not work because it's also dry. Whereas, depending on the health issue at the end of the day, right? Some people, they might need that dry weather, other people not. Another thing that they say is the healthcare system here is not world class. But in North Phoenix, for example, we have the Mayo Clinic, one of the top hospital systems in all of the country. So again, it's a matter of where you're going, but this is a reason that people cited was healthcare. All right, here's a big one that comes up quite a few times. And again, this is not necessarily my grievance, but this is what people have said. There's not a lot of things to do in Arizona. Now, if you watch this channel, Living in Arizona, we try to take you guys around and show you as much of the stuff to do around the great state of Arizona as possible. But people, even though they've seen those videos, or even though they may be aware of it, they still claim not a lot of activities and things to do, so it's a boring place for them. And so some people might say, well, if they're bored here, they're going to be bored no matter where they go. Well, I guess it just depends on what you like to do. But this is something that comes up. Not very interesting, not very entertaining, and boring. This is what people have said. Again, I didn't say that because I think it's a very exciting place to be and live. Now, here's something that keeps coming up in our community chat about reasons why people want to leave. They say the community of people. So they've noticed that some people in some areas... I got this Mojave County comment come in where they said the people in Mojave County are not very friendly. Now, a lot of this comes from political views or where they're originating from when they're moving here. You know, you've obviously heard about this resentment towards people from California, that pretty much every state in the West, including Idaho and Washington, feel about Californians. It's kind of unfair, really, but this is like a resentment. So they think that the first thing they got to do when they get here is change their license plate, change their license, make sure they erase all connections to California when they come here, because they say the people might actually treat them unfairly. But this is a thing that's come up, whether it's the political division or what have you, but they say the people sometimes are not friendly. Now, in my experience, I was shocked when I heard that, because I think Arizona's got some of the most friendly, welcoming people you'll find anywhere, really. And this is a really big one that's probably the most important thing that makes people want to go away or come or stay is family. Wherever your family is where your heart is. So if you have family, most of your family living somewhere far away and you're living in Arizona, that's going to affect your everything you're going to do, because on the holidays, you got to go clear across the country to go see them. You might miss them, but really, people leave Arizona a lot of times because their family is not nearby. But when your family's here in Arizona, you start to make it a home. If your family's far away, it's going to be really hard to make Arizona a home, from what I've discovered based on what people have said in our communities. Now, here's another reason why people say they want to leave Arizona. They want the four seasons. They want the green. They want greenery. Well, you can get four seasons and greenery in Arizona. This is what's so surprising. Prescott, Flagstaff, they get four seasons, no doubt about it. I mean, you go up to Sedona and Oak Creek Canyon, and you go to Flagstaff, you're going to find the fall foliage. You know, you're going to find those trees that are going to have the different colors, everything from the reds to the oranges to the yellows. You know, these trees are going to change color. That's fall, right? And then you're going to get snowpack in Flagstaff and the high country. But people seem to think that, again, Arizona, only Phoenix and Tucson. So because of that, everyone thinks, well, we don't get four seasons, we don't get the color, we don't have greenery, we only have brown desert and this and that. Well, at the end of the day, again, I think these people are just finding a reason to leave, but this is a reason people cited. All right, guys, so I just went through a whole list of why people say they want to leave Arizona. Again, this is not my list, this is what people are saying, so it's not me, it's what people have said. And I would say, overall, I understand why This place is not for everyone. They always think the grass is greener on the other side. So when they move here, they're expecting their life to change in a positive direction. But they're not realizing that if they're unhappy over there and they don't fix that root cause of what's making them unhappy where they're coming from, that where they're going next, they're just going to be putting a Band-Aid on it to go into a different setting. So Arizona can work out really good for you, or it can work out not so good for you, depending on where you're at mentally, about your approach with the situation, because that's what's going to count the most, okay? So the grass isn't always greener on the other side. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this video, and we'll see you guys on the next one. Watch some more of these other videos also.